Hi, this is Marlon Balbastro from WizByte Creatives. And today I'm going to show you how to create neon light effect in Photoshop. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to WizByte Creatives, hit that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Alright, so let's get started.
WizByte Creatives.
The first step is to create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N. You can also go to File and New. To ensure that your result will look like mine, make the width 1920 pixels and height 1080 pixels and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. The background color is white. Click the lock icon to unlock the background and double-click it to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay and the gradient bar. Click the black-white thumbnail and the lower right stop. Click the color box and pick a soft color that works with your subject. You can always change it later if you want. Since I already know the color, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field, 0F527. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. Check reverse, and make the style, radial. The angle is 0 and the scale is 150%. Open your horizontal type tool. Open your list of fonts and pick one that has wide areas within the characters. I'm using Limelight Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make it size 555 points so as to comfortably fit within my document. You can always adjust the font size later if you need to. Make its aliasing sharp. Click on your document and type out the character. To move it, open your Move tool. Double-click the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke, and make the size 15 pixels, the position is center and the opacity 100%. Make the fill 0%. Create group by pressing Ctrl or Command G. I'll name it Text 1. Double-click it to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay and the gradient bar. Click the black-white thumbnail and the lower left stop. Click the color box and pick a soft color that works with your subject. You can always change it later if you want. Since I already know the color, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field, FA2C49. For its location, type in 20%. Click the lower right stop, which is white. I'll type it into the hexadecimal field, 1A84F9. And for its location, type in 60%. The blend mode is linear dodge and the opacity is 100%. Make the style, linear and the angle 0 degree and the scale is 100%. Make the fill 0%. Duplicate the layer 2 times by pressing Ctrl or Command J. I'll name it Text 2 and Text 3. Open the Text 2 group folder and double-click on Text Layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke, and make it size 10. Next, open the Text 3 group folder and double-click on Text Layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke, and make it size 5. Make the text one layer active and convert it to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 20 pixels. Make the text 3 layer active and convert it to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 1 pixel. Open the photo and drag it. Once you're happy with its size and position, press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. Next, we'll separate the subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, make its radius anywhere between 50 and 70 pixels. Drag the tool over the inside of your subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click Add Layer Mask. To move it, open your Move tool. Make text 3 layer active and shift-click the text 1 layer to make all the characters active. Then, place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. I'll name it Text, but you can name it whatever you like. Drag the text folder to the top. Make the layer mask thumbnail active and open your polygonal lasso tool. Open your brush tool and set your foreground color to black. Brush inside the selection that you'd like to erase jutting outside your letter. Drag the model layer to the top of text folder. Open your adjustment layer then select levels. Click the small arrow to clip to layer. Make the bright output levels 175. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make the size 100 pixels and the hardness 0%. Its opacity and flow are both 100%. Set foreground to black. Brush the area that need to highlight. Next, create gradient fill. Click gradient and the gradient bar. Click the black-white thumbnail and the lower right stop. Click the color box and pick a soft color that works with your subject. You can always change it later if you want. Since I already know the color, I'll type it into the hexadecimal field, FA2C49. For its location, type in 20%. Click the lower right stop, which is white. I'll type it into the hexadecimal field, 1A84F9. And for its location, type in 60%. Make the style linear and the angle 0 degree and the scale is 100%. Set the blending mode to soft light then create clipping mask. Click Layer Mask Thumbnail then press Ctrl or Command I. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft round brush. Make the size 100 pixels and the hardness 0%. Its opacity is 20%, but you can increase it if you want. Flow is 100%. Set foreground to white. Brush the area that need to highlight. Duplicate the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Create clipping mask. Set the blending mode to linear dodge. Double-click it on layer mask thumbnail and make the feather 75 pixels. Make the fill 30%. Duplicate the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Create clipping mask. Change the blending mode to color. This is Marlon Balbastro from Wizbyte Creatives. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.